Hi, my name is Jens Klein, and in my last part of my mini-series about authentication and authorization, I will talk about LDAP integration into Plone. And this includes also Active Directory from Microsoft, as this is also an LDAP behind the scenes. LDAP is really an old protocol. It originates in the early 80s, and it was first a very complex specification called DEP, and you really don't want to know what it is. And L stands for lightweight, and even LDAP is complex. So today it's a broadly used protocol and database, and if you have the need of more complex user management, it's very likely that your organization uses LDAP because it scales and it's mature, and there are a lot of free software solutions around. We have the Open LDAP server, the 389 directory server, the Apache directory server, all open source solutions, and also commercial ones like Active Directory from Microsoft, Open Directory from Apple, eDirectory from Novell, Tivoli from IBM, or the Oracle Internet Directory. So lots of big names in here, and it's very well documented. It has some industry standard base schemas available, and you can extend it by your own schemas as you like. Now let's get past plugins LDAP into our Plone. I have here a mini build out, a very simple one, and I want to add past plugins LDAP. I take my editor and then I add here pass plugins LDAP to the X, and that's almost it. Additionally, you need to ensure to have all dependencies, like given here in the PyPy page for pass plugins LDAP installed in your system. If you have not Ubuntu or Debian based distribution, then you may need to translate this to your system requirements. Once I have it in here, I run build out and my system fetches pass plugins LDAP and all dependency needles. Now after build out run and I started my instance and I created a Plone site, and now we can install the plugin in site setup add-ons. Here we have the LDAP Active Directory support. Just install it. And now we have this add-on activated, and under users here on the right or in the overview, LDAP AD support. I started up a local test server, so the default settings are already okay. We have here a connection. We have configured the LDAP on the test port. We have a manager user in this LDAP server with a password. And we have several settings. And also where to fetch the users and assign user attributes, assign property sheet to LDAP attributes, and the same for the groups. Also important, the cache settings. You usually want to cache your LDAP queries because otherwise your Plone can get really slow. And we use memcached, so provide a memcached server. It's easy to install and configure it here properly. So this is only a rough overview about the settings. If you really want to go into detail, I can recommend the talk of Fred van Dijk at the Barcelona 2017 Plone conference about LDAP integration with user and group search. He really goes into depth, has a lot of hints about successful troubleshooting and so on. Watch it if you want to get really into it. Pass plugins LDAP is really an open source community project. If you want to contribute, it's very easy. Just create a pull request, ping us, use community.plone.org to ask questions and so on. We really try to help you. Keep in mind, it's a volunteer-based project, but also commercial support is available by some of the contributors, like Fred or me or others. If you run into problems with your LDAP, it's almost a problem with the data or understanding the data you have in your LDAP and how to query it. So it's important to get insights of your LDAP directory, how it is organized, what are the properties in there, and so on. A great tool to get the information out of LDAP is Apache Directory Studio. You can download it for Linux, macOS, and Windows, and let's have a look here at the screenshots. You can really inspect your directory tree, get insight in your directories, look at the properties, you can do your own queries, you can copy queries over from Plone logs, and so on and so on. So this is really helpful. Parse plugins LDAP in the wild is used in several installations, also in large organizations with several 10,000 of users. If you have lots of users, you might need some additional fine-tuning, but it works. Keep in mind, Parse plugins LDAP is meant read-only to LDAP servers. We haven't implemented write operations, and if we would do so, things get difficult. So usually LDAP data is managed centrally in the organization and you only want to read it. It is possible to query two LDAP servers by using two plugins. You can add a second plugin manually. So it's also possible to only have the users from LDAP and manage the groups in Plone. At the end, LDAP is complex, and so integration into Plone is also a bit more complex. But with the right tools and introspection, it's possible, and you will get it done. So this is the end of this mini-series on authentication and authorization. Thank you for listening, and bye-bye!